Well, hello, my name is Steve, and welcome to another family service, which, as you can see, is still taking place online. But even though we can all meet together in church, it's great we can join together via video to worship God. And today, we're going to be looking in the Bible at another one of Jesus' I am statements. That's where Jesus tries to describe to people what he's like using everyday objects. And the object Jesus says he's like today is this. I don't know if you just see what it is. It is a gate. Jesus said, "I am the gate." Well, what did he mean by that? Well, I suppose, where have you seen a gate before? Maybe you've seen one on the way into a garden or a field or maybe an animal pen. And you go through the gate to get into somewhere. And that might help us think about why Jesus said, "I am the gate." And we're going to be looking at that today, and here's what we're going to be doing. We're going to start, as we usually do, with a welcome and finding out what's been going on in our weeks. Then we're going to have a game. Then it's going to be our story, finding out about Jesus saying, "I am the gate." Then we're going to have our craft, and we'll be back in our recycling bins for that. We're having a memory verse. Then it's our action song, and finally we're going to close in prayer. And we're going to begin, as we usually do, with a welcome and finding out about what's been happening to each other this week. It's a difficult time being in lockdown, but it's still good to take time to think, what's something good about my week? What's something I'm thankful for? And that's what we're going to do now. And shall we start with Theo? Let's get him in here for this. And here's Theo. Do you want to give a little wave to say hello to anyone out there? No, that's all right. You're still a bit shy. Now, Theo, what we are doing is saying something good about our week, something that we are thankful for. What would you say? Not sure. I'll tell you what I would say. I would say that somehow during lockdown, the class that Theo and I do together on Mondays is still going. So we're very thankful for that. Shall we show them a couple of pictures from it? Here's some pictures from this week's class, which had a jungle theme. This is you dressed up as a giraffe and dressed up as a monkey. Those are great photos, weren't they? So that's something we're thankful for. Do you want to say goodbye, Theo? And just like that, Theo is gone again. Well, thank you so much for those of you that sent in photos and videos of what you've been doing this week. What are some of the things that you're thankful for? Let's have a look at a few of them now. We're going to start with Elijah. You can see him in this photo here. He's very thankful for his Playmobil figures. They've been helping him with his spelling homework, which is what he's doing here. We've also had a photo from Phoebe. She's very thankful for being able to go down the park and do some leaf rubbing. You can see her with some crayon and some paper in this photo. And we've also got a photo from their mum. This is Rosie, and she's very thankful for prayer. She says here she's doing a prayer experiment for Sandpit. It's where you put a post-it note on a bathroom mirror and you try and pray around that subject. And prayer's a great thing to be thankful for anytime we can talk to or listen to God. So that's what Elijah, Phoebe and Rosie have been thankful for this week. And also we've heard from Jessica and Susanna. You can see them in this picture here. They're very thankful for the chance to go outside and play on their scooter and their bike, even though it's been a bit wet and rainy this week. We've even got some video of them. Here's Susanna on her scooter. You can see she's very confident now, going around there in the wet, loving it, I'm sure. Also, we've had a video of Jessica on her bike. She's been brilliant on her bike this week, and you can see her going around on that. They're very thankful for their scooter and their bike. We've also got another video from Henry. Here's Henry here. He's been learning the different parts of his body this week. Let's have a little listen and see how he's doing.
Where are your toes? Toes, where are your toes? Good boy. Where are your hands, Henry? Where are your eyes? Where is your nose? Where's your mouth?
Wow, Henry, that was very impressive. That was amazing. Well, say thank you so much to all of you who sent in your photos and videos. But now it's the turn of everyone watching to go around the people where you are and ask, what's been something good about your week? What's been something you're thankful for? Maybe pause the video and we'll gather back together after you've done that. Let me just pause it now. Well, hopefully you were able to share some of the good things about your week. I know it can be hard at this time during lockdown, but even at a difficult time, it's good to remember some of the things that we're thankful for, some of the things we want to thank God for. And again, in the coming week, if you've got any photos and videos of what you've been doing, please do send them in and we'll put your photo in next week's video as well. Now, I think it's time for us to have our game. It's called the Laser Door Challenge. And I'm going to show you how to do it. And for it, we're going to need some tape that I have here. We're going to need some red wool and we're going to need a door. And my door's just over there. So I'll meet you over there in a second, okay? And here we are at my kitchen door. Now, doors and gates are things that you go through to get somewhere else. In this case, you go through it to get into our kitchen. And so my challenge is to see if we can go through this door to get into the other room. Let's see if I can do that now. Ta-da! Well, of course, that's not going to be the challenge. That will be far too easy just to do it that way. I promised you a laser door challenge, so we need to add some pretend lasers to our door. And I'm going to do that using some red wool and some tape. Let me just add them to it now. And as you can see now, we've got some lasers across our door with our red wool. That's going to make getting through it a bit harder because this is the challenge. We've got to try and get through the door now without touching any of the lasers, without touching any of the wool. Now, I will admit that I'm not very good at this, so I've made my gap quite large. But when you try this in your house, you can make the gap smaller, whatever size you want, to give yourself more of a challenge. So what I have to do is to try and go through the door now without touching or setting off any of the lasers. Let me see if I can do that. So it's quite hard. I'm just going to be really careful. So I'm going to get a leg in first, just there, and then duck down. Oh, that was rubbish. Right, okay, I'll try again. Go down, not touch that, and then lift the leg up. Oh, that's really difficult. Oh, okay, hopefully you're going to be better at this game than me. Why don't you try setting up some wool across your door and try the laser door challenge at your house and see if you can do it with narrower gaps than mine. Why don't you try the laser door challenge in your house with your door this week? And maybe you could send us in some pictures and videos of you trying it. Be great to share them with everyone else next week. And I think we'd all especially love to see some photos or videos of some of the adults trying that as well. Hopefully you'll do a bit better than me. Now, in today's story, we're looking at Jesus saying, "I am the gate." Now, in our game, we went through the door to get somewhere else, to get into the room. And when we think about a gate, we go through the gate to get somewhere else, into a field, into a barn, into a garden. We go through the gate to get somewhere else. And that's a bit about what Jesus is telling us in today's passage. Jesus saying, "I am the gate. You go through me to get somewhere else." And in a moment, Tim is going to read to us the passage from John chapter 10, where Jesus says, "I am the gate." Now, you might recognize part of this passage. It's part of the bigger passage we heard a few weeks ago when Jesus said, "I am the good shepherd." So we'll be thinking a bit about sheep and shepherds as well. But this time, instead of saying, "I am the shepherd," Jesus is saying, "I am the gate." Well, let's hear that read to us now by Tim. Over to you.
This week's reading is from John chapter 10, verses 1 to 10. Jesus said, "I tell you for certain that only thieves and robbers climb over the fence instead of going in through the gate to the sheep pen. But the gatekeeper opens the gate for the shepherd, and he goes in through it. The sheep know their shepherd's voice. He calls each of them by name and leads them out. When he has led out all of his sheep, he walks in front of them, and they follow, because they know his voice. The sheep will not follow strangers. They don't recognize a stranger's voice, and they run away." Jesus told the people this story, but they did not understand what he was talking about. Jesus said, "I tell you for certain that I am the gate for the sheep. Everyone who came before me was a thief or a robber, and the sheep did not listen to any of them. I am the gate. All who come in through me will be saved. Through me they will come and go and find pasture. A thief comes only to rob, kill, and destroy. I came so that everyone would have life and have it in its fullest.
Thank you, Tim. Well, as you heard in that reading, Jesus is talking about sheep once again and the people that look after them. You've probably worked out by now that when Jesus lived, sheep were a pretty common sight. They were all around. But they're not really so familiar for us, so some of the stuff that Jesus is talking about might seem a bit strange and a bit unusual. So I thought I'd try and explain what Jesus is saying using my field and toy sheep here. Let's have a closer look. And here we are. This is a bit what things might have looked like if you were a sheep when Jesus was telling this story. You can see our sheep are able to wander around here and eat lots of lovely grass. Yum, 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 yum. Lovely, lovely grass. And here we are during the day. But at night, this would be a really dangerous place to be if you were a sheep. When it gets dark, you get wild animals that come out that might attack the sheep. You get thieves and all other sorts of dangers that might want to harm the sheep. So we need to keep the sheep somewhere safe. And that's what we have here. We'd have a sheep pen, a place where the sheep could be at night that would keep them safe. Whenever Jesus was telling this story, it'd probably just be a stone wall and a little gap like this here. So what would happen at night is the sheep would go into the sheep pen. And to do that, they'd have to go through our gap here. So it's starting to get dark. Let's move our sheep into our sheep pen. Here we go. Let's bring some of the little lambs in too. They come in through the gap in our walls. One by one, the sheep come in through the gap into the sheep pen. And here's our last one, inside, through the gap into our sheep pen. So now our sheep are all in the pen, nice and safe for the night. And the only thing we have to do is to close this gap off here to make sure they're kept nice and safe. Well, when Jesus told this story, rather than using an actual gate made of wood or metal, what would happen is the shepherd himself would lie down across this gap. He would be the gate to the pen, keeping the sheep inside nice and safe. So to go into the pen, the sheep would literally go through the gap here, go through the shepherd, who would be like a gate. The shepherd would be a gate so they could get into the pen. And the only way they could get into the pen was through this gate where the shepherd himself would lie. Now, when Jesus usually talks about sheep, he's talking about people. People like me, people like you, people like every one of us. And that is what's happening here. Jesus is talking about sheep, but he's meaning us as people. And Jesus says that the sheep should be in the pen at night. They want to be safe and they want to be secure. And we should want to be with God the Father. We should want to be safe, to be saved with God the Father. And how does the sheep get into the pen? Well, the sheep goes into the pen through the gate. And how do we get to be with God the Father? Well, Jesus is saying you get to be with God the Father by going through the gate that is Jesus. Through Jesus, we get to be with God the Father. Through Jesus, we get to be safe, to be saved with God the Father. And in this picture we have here of the sheep with the shepherd as the gate, it's one of a good life for the sheep. They're safe, they're protected, they're looked after, they're leading a great life. And Jesus said, that's what life with God the Father is like for us. It's life to the full, the fullest life, the best life that we can lead. It's the life that we were created for. So how do we get this life with God? Through Jesus. Through Jesus the gate, we can have life with God the Father. So when Jesus is saying, I am the gate, he's saying that through him, we can get to God the Father. Through Jesus, we are saved. And to help us remember Jesus saying, I am the gate, I thought on our craft today we could make our very own gate. Now, because it's lockdown, I'm not going to use any fancy craft materials. Again, I'm just going to use some of the things that I found in my recycling. And for this, you're just going to need some cardboard that you can cut out into strips. maybe an old pizza box or an old envelope, or I've got the inside of a bit of packaging here. Just some bit of card that you can cut into strips. And as well as that, you'll need some glue and some scissors. You'll need some crayons to decorate it with and a pen. That's what we need. Let's find out how to do it now. So here we are with everything we need for our craft today. What we're going to do, first of all, is to use our cardboard to cut out some bars or strips to make our gate from. Let me just show you an example of what I mean. I'm just going to get one piece of cardboard here, and what we want is a thinnish long bar. So I'm just, doesn't have to be too exact, going to cut out a rough rectangle shape like this here, and then I'm going to cut off a bar or strip of cardboard like this here. Of course, what you've got to do, basically make some bars that are this shape. Now, we're going to need four bars that are roughly this length. So I've got my piece of card, and I'm going to cut out four bars from that. There's two, and then something similar as well. There is three, and finally there is four. So we have four long bars like this here. Now we're also going to need two shorter bars and one longer bar. So let me get a little bit of card for our shorter bars, and I'm going to do them a little bit shorter than those. So here we are. I'm just going to cut this card into two. So we've got four long one and two short one, and then we need one very long bar. So let me get a sheet of paper out here again, and I'm going to cut out our very long bar. Now, the good thing is that when you do it, you can make it very, very long and then cut it back afterwards. So I'm going to cut it quite long because I'm not entirely sure what I need. We're going to be finished with the card now. We just have this. So what we have is one long bar, four medium-sized bars like this, and two short bars that we have here, and that's what we need to make our gate. So now we need to just stick together all the bits and pieces that go to make up our gate, and to do that we start with our two short bars and then place our four medium sized ones across them, roughly equally spaced along like this here. You can begin to see the gate shape emerge like this, and then what we need to do is to put some glue down to stick these long bars onto the two short ones. So let me do that now. I'm going to turn them over and put some dabs of glue in the corner to stick them on here. So I've got my glue, give it a little bit of a shake. So let me just put a dab of glue in each corner. And this is where you maybe want to do this on some tablecloth or a bit of scrap paper so you don't get this everywhere. So I'm just going to put those little dabs of glue in the corner, and then we're going to start building our gate. We start down at the bottom with our two strips here, and we're going to put it across like this, and then we're going to put one up at the top just like that, and then we're going to put our two strips in the middle, try and roughly evenly spaced across our gate like this here, and then our final one is this. Now you'll notice we still have one strip left, and that's our great big long strip, because what the long strip's going to do is going to go across our gate at a diagonal like this here. Now you'll see that mine is slightly longer than I need, so I'm just going to cut off the end. You might want to trim yours to roughly the length you need as well. Just needs to go across the length of the gate, and again we dab some glue in the corner here, and we're going to put that across and form our gate. Now there's one thing I want to put on this as well. We're saying this is to remind us when Jesus said, "I am the gate." So on our big long strip that we've just stuck on, I'm going to write Jesus to remind us when Jesus said, "I am the gate." Jesus is a way that we can be saved. We come through Jesus to be God with God the Father. And there you can see is our gate. Now our gate doesn't look that exciting at the moment, and that's where our crayons or pens come in. What we're going to do now is take a few minutes to decorate and colour in our gate, whatever colours you want, whatever style you want, so it looks a bit more interesting than just the brown colour that I have at the minute. And while we do that, I'm going to play a song. The song, it's Matt Redman's You Alone Can Rescue. And it's a song all about Jesus rescuing us, Jesus saving us, Jesus bringing us back to God the Father. So while that plays, let's finish off our gates and decorate them, and we'll meet back after that.
Who, oh Lord, could save themselves, their own soul could heal? Our shame was deeper than the sea, your grace is deeper still. And you alone can rescue, you alone can save, you alone can lift us from the grave. You came down to find us, let us out of death. To you alone belongs the highest praise.
Here's my final gear, all decorated and ready to use. Hopefully you had fun making and decorating yours too. And it reminds us that through the gate, the sheep get into the pen. And through Jesus, we can be with God the Father. We can be saved through Jesus. And as well as our craft to help us remember that Jesus is the gate, I thought we could learn a verse from today's passage as well. It's John chapter 10, verse 9, and it says, I am the gate. All who come in through me will be saved. As we learned about earlier, Jesus is the gate. Through Jesus we are saved. Through Jesus we can be with God the Father. Now to help us remember that verse, I thought I could teach us a few actions using our hands to help the verse really get stuck in here. So let me teach those actions to you now. It starts with Jesus said, so our action for Jesus is just where we use a finger to touch like our wrists like this. So Jesus, do one hand each. Jesus, and then said is touch our chin with a finger and move it away. Said. Jesus said. And of course we're going to learn the action for the gate. So gate is our two hands like this, and then just move the front one to open like a gate. All who come in, so all is going to be this here, come in through. Now through is a great one. We hold a palm out like this and just put a bit of a gap in our fingers and move the other hand through that gap. So this is literally going through. Through me will be saved. So we clasp our hands and bring them in close to us. So putting all that together, it's Jesus said, I am the gate. All who come in through me will be saved. John chapter 10, verse 9. Have you got the hang of that? Well, let's try it all together with the words and actions to help us get that memory verse into our head. Let's try it all together. Ready? Jesus said, I am the gate. All who come in through me will be saved. John chapter 10, verse 9. And let's try it once again to really get that memory verse stuck. Okay, let's do it. You ready? Jesus said, I am the gate. All who come in through me will be saved. John chapter 10, verse 9. And hopefully, with our little gate Jesus here we made in the craft and our memory verse, it'll really help us to remember Jesus saying, I am the gate. Through Jesus, we are saved. Through Jesus, we can be with God the Father. And now it's time for our action song, a chance for us to worship God with our voices and with our hands and arms as we act along to the song. The song this week is City on a Hill. It's all about letting Jesus' light shine out from us, letting Jesus' light in us change the world around us. So now I'm going to hand over to our band of Ruth, Sarah and Alwyn.
Shine, let your light shine.
Well, thank you so much to our band. Hopefully you enjoyed singing and acting along to that at home. And now for the final part of our service today, we're going to pray. I'm going to hand over to Sarah now to lead us in our prayers.
Hello, everyone. So today we've been learning about Jesus telling us, "I am the gate." And I was wondering how we might be able to remember that. Now, most of us don't go through gateways in our daily lives very often, but we do go through a lot of doorways. As you can see, I, in my house, am sitting in a doorway, and I reckon that probably you've got several different doorways in your home as well. So I wondered if you could pick a particular doorway, and then every time you go through it this week, you could use it as a reminder of what Jesus said about him being the gate, and you could say a little thank you prayer to God as you go through. So let's spend a little bit of time together now in prayer. When I say, "Lord, you are the gate," you can respond, "Please protect us." So let us pray. Dear Jesus, thank you that you are the gate of the sheep, that you love and protect us, and that through you we are able to come to God. Just as you defend us, your followers, we pray for your protection over our world, our community, and our church. As the world continues to be affected by the COVID-19 pandemic, we pray for the vaccines being developed around the globe. We ask for you to protect and guide the people developing them, and for those making decisions about who should receive the vaccine first. Lord, you are the gate. Please protect us. As we live through a second lockdown in England and cannot see many of our family and friends, we pray for hope and strength to sustain us. We ask for you to protect and comfort all the people who are feeling lonely or anxious, and all those who are grieving for loved ones who have died. Lord, you are the gate. Please protect us. As we near the beginning of Advent and the run-up to Christmas, which we know will look very different this year, we pray for all those leading our churches, particularly St. George's. We ask you to protect and strengthen them as they seek new and different ways to reach out to people and spread the joyful news of Jesus' birth. Lord, you are the gate. Please protect us. We pray all these prayers in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Sarah. And let me finish our time together by praying this prayer of blessing on us all. The Lord bless us and keep us. The Lord make his face shine upon us and be gracious to us. The Lord turn his face towards us and give us peace. Amen. Well, thank you so much for joining with us today as we worship God and learn about Jesus saying, "I am the gate." It's through Jesus that we are saved. Through Jesus, we get to be with God the Father. And next week, we'll be looking at our final "I am" statement. So hopefully you can join us for that. Until then, have a good week and goodbye.